Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. This is going to be the second video of my project, which is all about distorted urbanization. In this video, we are going to talk about distorted urbanization. What is distorted urbanization? What are the causes and effects of distorted urbanization? How to avoid distorted urbanization, and a little bit extra information about distorted urbanization. But first of all, let's do a little bit review. In the last video, which is my first video of this project, I talked about urbanization. What is urbanization? What are the types of urbanization? What are the causes and effects of urbanization? I mentioned that urbanization is the increasing proportion of the city and towns in population actually. I mentioned also that distorted urbanization is one of the types of urbanization. Urbanization has basically two types, proper and distorted urbanization. I mentioned proper urbanization in the first video, and in this video I am going to talk about only distorted urbanization. In the first video, I said that urbanization interacts with distribution, development process, industrialization and economic growth. During these processes, we can see the busy city life, and this causes for urbanization to take another dimension. If this dimension is executed in plans and improves in according to a plan, we call this situation as proper urbanization. But if the dimension is executed without any plans and wrong managements, we call this situation as distorted urbanization. In this video, I am going to detail this sentence. But first of all, I just want to thank you all for your good feedbacks about my first video and messages, your supporting with sharing my videos and also subscribing my channel. So thank you all for these actions. Let's talk about what is distorted urbanization. Distorted urbanization is the growth of a city without any planning and control powers. This means that a city, for example, Istanbul, has no city planning or no control powers to check the situation in Istanbul. What is the situation? I said that situation in Istanbul, but the situation means that the illegal and legal buildings in Istanbul, how urbanization get bigger in Istanbul. So a control power should be check this situation in a city to see how distorted urbanization happens, to see how urbanization gets bigger. Distorted urbanization spoils the historical, natural and cultural structure of the city. This is actually the effects of distorted urbanization. I am going to talk about it in the next page. Let's talk about how distorted urbanization starts. It starts with a sudden migration wave to a big cities from countryside, and also increasing the population growth happens to improve the distorted urbanization in a city, because the requirements get bigger in city when population gets bigger, and also when migration wave happens to a city, also shanty houses and towns happen. Shanty houses are the illegal buildings that low-income people build on an empty places. Because of the need of housing, people build makeshift houses by their own. We can see shanty houses in a city that has distorted urbanization, because people build shanty houses without any planning. Distorted urbanization also happened without any planning. So we can connect these two situations by planning and control powers. If there is a control power, the government can see a number of shanty houses in the city, and also this can give an information about distorted urbanization level in the city. As I mentioned in here, again, shanty houses built without any planning, permission, license. Every legal building has a license to be built in a place. Shanty houses built without any license or something, permission. License shows the permission that someone can build a building in a place. I connected these two situations. Shanty houses affect distorted urbanization a lot. The main cause of increase in shanty houses is rapid population growth and also migration, uncontrollable power, planning lack of infrastructure. These are the main causes of shanty houses. This is the general explanation of distorted urbanization. Growth of a city without any planning, control powers, also spoils the historical natural structure of the city. So this is the basically what is distorted urbanization. Distorted urbanization is related with shanty houses by control power planning, because shanty houses are illegal buildings that placed on empty places without any planning, license or permission. Let's talk about what are the causes and effects of distorted urbanization. Distorted urbanization is a very important problem in the world that can affect our future. In this direction, there are many reasons for the formation of distorted urbanization. The biggest reason for distorted urbanization is the inadequate attention urban planning receives from political authority. Distorted urbanization is a fundamentally wrong urban planning problem, including population growth and similar issues. Distorted urbanization occurs due to many problems like the unplanned design of the streets administrators think of, not making a sustainable decision and allowing illegal buildings to be built. These are the main causes of distorted urbanization. I want to give a significant addition to this, to causes of urbanization. Distorted urbanization is not a problem of architects and construction companies, because architectural companies have to work in line with the published contract rules. Therefore, architectural companies can't contribute in any way to the planned development of the city. If there is no power or planning in the region, the contracts related to the city planning also operate according to that. As a result of this, the city grows in an unplanned manner, and the unit responsible for this growth is the city planning department or the Ministry of Environment and Urbanization. So this is an important information about distorted urbanization causes, because everyone thinks that distorted urbanization is the problem of architects. As I mentioned in the last sentences, this is a wrong statement. Another cause of distorted urbanization is rapid population growth and migration to the city from countryside. Also, modernization, industrialization, migration from the countryside to the city, and development in an uncontrolled manner. The explanations are given above can be examples for the causes of distorted urbanization. Let's talk about effects of distorted urbanization. We can see that distorted urbanization has many effects, such as the impact on natural resources, infrastructure, our future, and on the country's economy and politics in a bad way. It affects ease of life. Distorted urbanization has consequences that mainly affect our ease of life. First of all, the biggest effect of distorted urbanization is natural resources. The use of consumption of water resources increases, and our water resources decreases according to that. The requirement of water increases, and that happens to decrease in water resources. In another effect, the rate of urbanization is increasing, which causes air pollution. The increase of urbanization multiplies the problems arising from the convenience of living. For example, increase in traffic, transportation, lack of education, industrialization, the rate of air pollution increases. Traffic also causes to have noise pollution too. So air pollution and noise pollution, as I mentioned in the first video, are also the effects of distorted urbanization too. It's both effects of urbanization and distorted urbanization. But if the distorted urbanization level gets bigger, the air pollution and noise pollution level gets bigger too, because the population, because we can see the growth in the population. As we can see in actually Istanbul, our trees are cut down, nature is not being cared of. As we can see on the internet, the places with forests and natural environments are open to a zoning plan. That means that buildings can be built in these places. Therefore, one of the effects of distorted urbanization is soil. Conversely, with the need of soil, trees are cut down. Nature is not being cared of. And conversely, concrete is used. Concreting also disrupts the balance of nature, and this happens to risk of disasters like earthquakes. Earthquake is such an important problem. As a result of all these effects, there are consequences entail social unhappiness, destruction of the historical buildings, historical structures, not protecting the architectural structure of Istanbul, and not establishing the state order. So these are the main causes and effects of distorted urbanization. For causes, I said that migration, population growth, wrong city planning, and control power. For effects, I said that natural resources such as water, air, and soil. Also air pollution, traffic, and earthquakes. Let's talk about how to avoid distorted urbanization. Distorted urbanization is in a situation that can pose a danger in our world. It is a situation that causes bad appearance and allow various problems to occur in infrastructure systems and all necessary needs, such as transportation. The following actions should be taken to prevent unplanned urbanization, such as the zoning plans should be checked and revised again, because the zoning plans, city plans, are not so good in city. The city plan should be prepared again by considering basic needs such as school, hospital, transportation, as I mentioned before. It should be determined whether all buildings are legal or illegal. Requirements of a city should be calculated again. According to these things, all requirements of a city should be calculated again. And also for possible disasters, distorted urbanization effects on earthquakes. Places such as streets, parks should be revised in a planned manner. As I mentioned that this distorted urbanization is the growth of a city without any plan. So basically we should change the city plan to avoid distorted urbanization. After talking about how to avoid distorted urbanization, I just want to give some extra information about distorted urbanization. In this video, I talked about legal and illegal buildings. Legal structures approved by the ministry. So legal building structures are approved by the Ministry of Environment and Urbanization. So legal buildings has a permission and license to be built in a place. Illegal buildings are buildings that are constructed without following any rules, inspection power, and not taking the land registry, floor regulations, and similar rules into consideration. Such as buildings cannot be built under normal conditions. However, it is impossible to detect illegal structures in a country or city without control power. I write the number of illegal buildings in here, in Istanbul. In a line with a report published on 2019, it emphasized that there are 4 million illegal buildings in Istanbul. With this news, we can see the level of distorted urbanization in Istanbul. It's highly dangerous for us. Also, in 1960, there are 240,000. Because distorted urbanization can affect our future a lot. Natural resources are decreasing. Water resources are decreasing. Traffic is increasing. Concrete is increasing. All we need is natural resources. So this will be effect on our future. It is so highly dangerous for us. Because as I explained in the previous page, natural resources are decreasing, water resources are decreasing, air pollution and traffic is increasing, and all we need is natural resources in our world to be sustainable. So that affects our future too. As we can see, the number of illegal buildings increased a lot in 10 years. In 1960, the number of illegal buildings are 240,000. I think that this number is actually so much, but today there are 4 million. So, yes, in 1970, there are 600,000 illegal buildings. As we can see, in 1980, there are 890,000 illegal buildings, and in 2020, in this year, The number of illegal buildings in Istanbul is 4 million, more than 4 million. As I mentioned in the last page, our water resources are increasing in this year, 2020. So in this year, our water resources are decreasing, and I can't think that in our future, if the illegal buildings get so higher, I can't think the level of natural resources that, such as water resources, forests, trees. Natural resources are the only things to be sustainable. So we shouldn't cut the trees. We should use our water effectively. We should revise our zoning plan. We should revise our city planning. We should change the system in our city. I just want you to know that distorted urbanization is because of wrong city planning, and we should change this situation. We should know the importance of natural resources. We should know the importance of air, soil. We shouldn't use concrete. We should start to change the system. But the first step of the changing this situation is raise this information. No one knows the effects of distorted urbanization on our future and natural resources. So the first step is to change the system in Istanbul, in city planning and control power. We should spread out these informations. We should spread out what is distorted urbanization, how can distorted urbanization happen, and what are the effects of distorted urbanization. Also, how distorted urbanization is highly dangerous for us. As you can see in here, there are 4 million illegal buildings, and this probably get bigger in future. I just want you to spread out this video. This is not related with my project. This is a real life situation, real life example. So I talked about how to avoid this distorted normalization situation, but nothing is happening. So the first step of avoiding distorted normalization is knowledge. We should know everything about distorted normalization. This is the biggest thing of how to avoid distorted normalization. By spreading out this knowledge, by these informations, such as how to avoid distorted urbanization, what are the causes and effects of distorted urbanization, what is distorted urbanization, what are shanty houses, to get a better ease of life, to get a better air, to get a better natural resources, to get a sustainable city. I talked about in detail that what is distorted urbanization. What is shanty houses? As we can see in Istanbul, there are so many shanty houses, and this would be cause to improve in distorted urbanization. Also, I talked about causes of distorted urbanization, and I connected the causes of distorted urbanization with shanty houses. Also, urbanization. Also, how urbanization becomes to a distorted urbanization. I talked about that in this video. I just want to inform you about the importance of this situation, distorted urbanization in Istanbul. Actually, the goal of my project is this, to inform you. I would be so glad if you also read my blog posts on distorted urbanization, dinarerkol.blogspot.com. This is the end of this video. Thanks for listening to me. As you know, the product of my project, which is effects of distorted urbanization on natural resources, is not only YouTube channel. I am also writing blog articles, blog posts related with distorted urbanization, urbanization. You can find the same information, also more information in my blog page too, because the video shouldn't be so long, but in my blog page, there are so many informations about distorted urbanization. So I would be so glad if you read my blog posts too. You can find the link in my Instagram account too. This is the code of my Instagram account that I just want you to visit the website by this QR code. I am posting photos related with urbanization, distorted urbanization. Also, the important words that I talked in this video in a little explanation. I would be glad if you check it out my Instagram account, which is Project of Tourist. And also, you can find the reference part of this video in the explanation part of this video. So, again and again, thank you a lot for listening to me. See you soon till the next video.